In the midst of the racial turmoil that we're going through as a country right now, we've got a kind of a new controversy around voice actors that is spreading to comics. I'll explain why in a bit. Where, you know, you have people like Alison Brie apologizing for voicing an Asian American character in the show cartoon, BoJack Horseman. Is this helpful? Where does this all go? How does it cross over to comics? Well, let's talk about it for a minute. Hey everybody, this is Perch. This has been the kind of Twitter thing of the week, but it's going to roll other places. And a lot of people already have an opinion on this. There's a lot of hot takes about how ridiculous it is. This is kind of the woke Hollywood media, etc., talking about voice acting. That's fine. Everybody's welcome to their opinion on this, and I want to throw some other just thoughts your way. It's easy always to kind of have a gut reaction in one direction or another. People do it all the time. But it's often, I force myself to think critically. It's not a plug for Wes's channel, but why not? You should follow that. Subscribe. Hate him and me, by the way, if you haven't already. It's cool. You could listen to this trash audio every day. Anyway, you should think critically about things. And I think you should challenge yourself to, you know, test out what you believe. It's a good thing to do. It doesn't make you weak. So where the voice acting is concerned, the topic on the table is basically you have these characters of color who are animated, and then they hire white people to do it. And it hasn't really gone to this point yet, but there's also a decent amount of men that voice female characters, like on Bob's Burgers and other place. And, you know, the question becomes, well, if it's female characters, shouldn't a woman be doing the voice? Now, you know, this is one of those things where I think the producers, the creators, the people who work on these shows get to make this choice. I think if they want to be, you know, quote unquote authentic with the race or the gender or the sexuality even, that's their prerogative. I think they get to hire who they want and do what they want. And I think if somebody says we're going to only do it authentic, and or maybe they started out one way and then they had a revelation that they want to do it a different way, that's up to them. It's their show. It's their creation. They can live or die with the consequence. I'm seeing people post things like they should be stopped from changing the race of this character. And I'm like, I think it's their creation. They can do what they want. It's their call, just like it's your call to watch it or not. But I think that it starts to get, this is where it gets a little bit silly, is because as some comic people are retweeting this, some creators, they're saying this is reason why you need a African-American person writing, drawing Black Panther. This is why if you're going to do a book for Spider-Gwen, you should have a female creator. Rather than Jason Latour or Robert Rodriguez, you should have a female artist and writer team. And I think that's a dangerous slope for people to get on, because I think there's two parts to this. One is the spirit of it. And this is what I like to hope everybody's going for. And the hope is that twofold. One, that there's opportunities for everyone, every race, every gender, every sexual, everybody, whoever it is, there's opportunities for you. If you've got a good story to tell, there's an opportunity for you in comics. And anywhere, movies, TV shows, animation. I think that's a good thing. I think there should be opportunities for everyone. I don't think anyone should be excluded. And by the way, I haven't met, I'm sure some people think in the back of their heads, but I haven't met anybody who really wants to argue with that. Maybe they don't want to do it out loud, I don't know. But generally, that's my stance. I think everybody should have an opportunity. And also, I'll follow up by saying, I don't think that world exists quite right today. I do think that there's I think it's harder for some people to join than others. And I don't think it's always what you think. I have some friends in the comic industry who claim, and I think they've got some merit to back it up, that Latino writers have an extremely hard time getting into comics. They're excluded. They're locked out of the building. They have to basically kind of, you know, in their words, kind of gentrify themselves to go, you know, cuddle up to the Portland crowd or to the New York crowd in order to have a shot, because it's a closed network, and you know, Latino creators are just not there. You have to be in a different community in order to be seen. I don't know if that's true or not, but you know, that's a claim. That's not what you hear about on social media, but that's a claim. I think that the same thing has, I've heard this and from firsthand experience with creators who are friends of mine who are Asian, who have a career or some popularity over in the manga market over in Korea or in Japan, who come over to the US and they're not given the time of day. Now, is it because they're race or is it because they don't have a network? I think it's probably because of the networking piece of it. But I get it. I think that, okay, so I don't think the system is great today. And one reason why I stress this point is that there's a lot of noise about comics about, hey, we need to create that system. We need to give these people a shot. And yet the proposals I've seen about, hey, you know, retweet a person of color creator, do that today, help get them work, hire one. It doesn't seem like it's really solving the problem. It's solving it for a few, but it doesn't seem like it's solving the true goal of anyone can get into comics based on merit. Now, when I do shows, I did a Thinking Critical show over the weekend, and the topic comes up, hey, if you're conservative or Republican or religious, that you're also excluded. And this one is, a lot of people say it's very easy to prove. I think it's harder to prove because there are plenty of people who just don't talk about their politics. They just keep it to themselves and they haven't established careers. Yes. At the same time, I also think it's true that when you look at the bulk of creators kind of in mass, that, you know, people who are religious, deeply religious, are underrepresented. There are definitely some that are there. Christopher Priest is definitely there. And so I don't think it's all or nothing, but yeah, I think, this goes back to the system for comics, hasn't created an equal playing field yet based on merit. And I think there are some pretty amazing, I've made this comment before and I've gotten pushback on it, but I do believe very firmly that if you're running a comic company and you have a lot of comics, you know, a big portfolio, you would be wise to have a very diverse staff. Not because you're trying to look like the United Colors of Bennington when you take a company picture, but because the big value to diversity, in my mind, in companies, is one I almost never hear. And it's this: if you have a very diverse staff, you have very diverse ideas. And thus, your product becomes more powerful. You have people from lots of different walks of life, all with different viewpoints, all with different insights into how things work and how things operate. And if you can achieve some, you know, the best and the brightest with a very diverse staff, you've got something very powerful than if you went down to any one area. If you hired only people from Atlanta or only people from LA or only people from New York, you're limiting your diversity. Diversity is not just race, not just gender, not just sexuality. It's also location. It's life experience. It's rich and poor. There's a lot to go into diversity. But the DNA, the background, the resume of people in comics is often very similar. Even if there's many different colors represented, the background of how they got in is often very much the same. And it's why you get comic events and things that seem very much the same. It's why when we talk about we need ideas for digital and other things, it's you get the same ideas over and over. It's because diversity does, if true diversity, actually does bring in a lot of things. So I always add it. I'm very much in favor of it. I don't see a lot of these efforts angling us to either true diversity or true fairness in comics. So on a more kind of core level, a more dangerous level, you might say, I don't see it stopping the violence and the problems we're having. You know, the George Floyd case is terrible. It is a terrible case. You know, whatever background circumstances there is, you know, putting your foot on someone's neck for 8 minutes, you knew as kids that would kill somebody. That wasn't a good thing. But does making sure that the authentic kind of race or gender of a cartoon character voice that character, does that help that situation? I saw somebody make an argument that, you know, pushing back, basically somebody was making the same argument I did, which is, hey, I think we've lost track. We've lost the plot that there's some police reforms. There's some other things that need to take place. And, you know, going after cartoon voices is not, we're far astray. You know, we've got bigger problems to solve, basically. And the pushback was, It all has to start from somewhere. If you're going to build a racially tolerant, field, then it does exist here. There's quiet racism. There's standards that even in cartoons send a message and build an overall culture of racism. And I my answer to that is, I guess so, but I'm more urgent than that. I don't want to see people killed in the street because of their sexuality, because of their race. I don't want to see that. I want fairness from the police. I want justice to be blind. That's what our nation was founded on. That's what Western civilization is supposed to be. That is what I want. And I'm not interested in taking a long ride over the course of multiple generations of first we're going to solve the cartoon voices, and then we're going to solve the middle management, and then we're going to get a couple directors in there, and then we're going to get some banks, and then finally, in 50, 80 years, we're going to have racial equality. I'm in more of a hurry than that. I don't think it needs to take us that long to have reforms that, keep people from being killed. That's just my opinion. Now, I know I've gotten astray from comics, but I want to come back to it. I think this push for equality, I think there's a lot of the, racist and bigot and those kind of words gets thrown around. And I wish that people wouldn't throw them around so quickly, because I think it becomes a knee-jerk insult that doesn't, actually answer or solve anything over time. So I wish people were a little bit more careful with that. So I think they do damage to their causes. But, diversity, kind of the point I made earlier, I think comics right now needs more ideas. In many cases, it's stagnant. It needs other voices. It needs other outlooks. It does need that. I think that would be helpful. But I think we have to work really hard to build it. And I don't think we can build it by waving a magic wand on Twitter and say, go find your favorite POC friend, give them a job, problem solved. I don't think that solves diversity. So when I see a lot of these pushes of, hey, don't you care about diversity? Isn't this what diversity within comics means? I think to myself, you're not actually solving the problem. You're making sound bites, but nothing here actually solves a problem. And I think this is a problem that should be solved. I don't know. What do you think? One, does it matter? Let me know your honest opinion. I think the comments I get on my videos, I feel extremely fortunate on. It gives me a pang often that I'm not, able to have these conversations in real life with people. I would love it, because the kind of intelligent commentary I often get in the comments, not all of them, there's always, some jokers in there. It's fine too. I like a laugh as well. But there's some really thoughtful responses. So I wanted to thank everybody for doing that. Thank you. And let me know what you think. I do think diversity matters. I just don't think we're talking about diversity very much. We're talking about it a lot. I don't think we're actually talking about it, if you know what I mean. Anyway, that's my thought on the matter. Hey, like, subscribe, downvote, whatever you feel like doing, it's fine. And follow me on Twitter or Facebook at Comic Birch. And thanks for listening.